Thriller is one of the biggest albums ever. Thank you for your support, effort, and hard work. Michael Jackson.
1983. Le petit bonhomme a fait son chemin. Il fête son 500e album, Thriller, de Michael Jackson, et son 112e disque d'or. En fait, presque chaque fois qu'un disque de musique populaire américaine atteint les sommets, il est signé Quincy Jones.
Million copies sold and counting, Michael Jackson's Thriller is considered to be one of the greatest albums of all time. Well, tonight we're going to take you back to the photo shoot for the album's cover and the lost video of Michael in the makeup chair. It's another ET exclusive. An incredibly rare moment with 24-year-old Michael Jackson, one never seen before.
We're going to curl up a little bit, pour this water on it.
He's having his hair done for a photo shoot, a photo that would land on the cover of the biggest-selling record album of all time. In Thriller, the video, Michael wore red leather, but on the 1982 cover, it was that trademark white suit. Photographer Dick Zimmerman took that picture, and during Michael's hair and makeup session, he was also shooting this video.
I want to keep it where it is now unless there's a certain other look you want to use.
It was more than a year before the Pepsi commercial pyrotechnics that would set Michael's hair on fire and damage his scalp. But here he was already meticulous about his look.
It looks better when I keep it down. When I keep my hair down, look.
She said a few things that I thought were kind of interesting.
Well, I got pins in there to keep my hair down. Hair pins.
Oh, yeah.
My hair is
it wild?
Yeah.
Michael was at ease, joking with the stylist about those hairpins.
There's one. Uh-huh. Probably been in there for a year,
I saw a little curl that he had there that accidentally fell, and I wanted to pull down some curls, you know.
Put some curl at the end of water and play with the ends, you know.
It was all very low-key. Michael had no entourage, just one assistant. And when he couldn't choose an outfit from those brought for the shoot, album cover history was made.
He says, no, I just don't see anything I want to wear, you know. And I was wearing a white suit, you know. And he said, well, don't you have anything like that? And I said, you can wear my suit. We look like the same size. And he said, okay.
27 years later, Thriller's impact remains strong. After Michael's death, the single and album both returned to the record charts. And this salute at the VMAs on MTV moved Michael's sister Janet.
And to see them look so close to his movement, the way he was, it just touched me.
Janet also paid tribute to her brother on that show, and tomorrow MTV will premiere the making of Janet Jackson's Video Music Award tribute performance.
It was very emotional for me, and I was trying not to cry.
And Dick Zimmerman is paying tribute as well. Saddened by Michael's death, he has painted this homage, a composite from all their photo shoots together.
This image here was taken from the Michael and Lisa wedding portraits. I liked the guy. I really liked him. I respected him. I had fun with him. I was emotionally upset, of course, when he died. And I wanted to, paint something that showed, how I felt.
What a great moment in music history. And Monday right here on E.T., the Jackson Brothers' first interview together since Michael's death.
Starting Monday, E.T. takes you inside the Jackson Brothers' secret photo shoot going on right now.
Thank you.
Michael.
Okay, please sit down. We need you to sit, please, now. Would the still photographers please sit down now? We want to let the camera crews get some shots, and they can't see through you. Could you please sit down?
Michael, can you wait?
Say, in as much as I understand Marlin said I might have a word on the summit with Mr. Gorbachev, I'm very pleased the dates have been set, and it is very important that we have these conversations. Dialogue is important, and I'm looking forward to seeing Mr. Gorbachev here. Conversations with Mr. Shevardnadze have been well, and I will receive him here in the Oval Office tomorrow. I look forward to that. This is a time of a lot of dialogue and a lot of discussion, and I'm delighted that this is set.
Took the process an extra step, be it incorporating complex choreography or producing videos on the scale of a major movie, or just pushing himself to the edge of his creative mind. Well, in recognition of Michael's consistent efforts to maximize the effort and the quality of music video, and in recognition of his undeniable influence on the music industry and his creative integrity, it is MTV's pleasure to present Michael Jackson with the Video Vanguard Artist Award of the Decade. Now here is the one and only Adam Curry and MTV Chief Executive Officer Tom Freston to present Michael Jackson with this well-deserved award.
Adam Curry here on location in the Valley for an event that will go down in video history, the presentation of the Video Vanguard Artist of the Decade Award. Now, every year at the MTV Video Music Awards, we honor those artists whose work has left a lasting mark on the world of video. And we're here today to hand out the big one, the MTV Video Vanguard Artist of the Decade Award. And to call a recipient worthy is an understatement of epic proportion. Believe me, this guy really deserves it. Every single time we think we see him at his best, he just goes out and tops himself all over again. I'm talking, of course, about the one and only Michael Jackson. And I'd like to let the president, head honcho, and chief executive officer take it over from here. Tom Freston. Go ahead, Tom.
Thank you, Adam. Michael, everyone knows you as a gifted singer, dancer, musician, choreographer, composer, and performer. And I hope I didn't leave anything out. But we're here today really to highlight another of your accomplishments, which is your outstanding contribution to the video arts. Throughout the 80s, your work has expanded the art form. You're not afraid to tell a story, to take risks, to visually stimulate the audience, and of course, to give all those dancers a paycheck. I remember the excitement in 82 when Billie Jean broke. Then you followed that a few months later with Beat It. People everywhere were glued to their sets watching you on MTV. And with each passing video project, you've kept the excitement going. So on behalf of MTV and our audience, I'm thrilled to present you, the biggest selling recording artist of all time, with the award for MTV's Video Vanguard of the Decade. We can't wait to see what you have planned for us in the 90s. Congratulations.
It's very beautiful. Thank you very, very much, MTV. Wonderful. And to all the fans, I love you. Thank you very much.
For his revenge.
It's a rock band!
An extravagant two-song performance by Michael Jackson. It all started at rehearsals with Michael's large multi-generational chorus.
I am Vincent Patterson. I'm a choreographer and director.
He presented me with two pieces, Black or White and a new song from the album, Will You Be There? The first is about frustration of the world and violence, and the second is about questions.
What we intended to do was to make an urban environment that broke away and became a kind of a more spiritual environment. There were four licks at the back that raised the chorus people up. There was a big flying rig that came down. There was an elevator that carried the children down to the ground.
The Black or White performance also featured some serious pyrotechnics.
This is the main thing. Not the music, it's the pyro. In special effects, everything has to be tested. Fire in the hole! See, that was too much. Oh, that looks nice. We want to make sure that it's safe for Michael.
Okay.
Fire in the hole!
I was burned because of this kind of stuff.
Another surprise for fans was the addition of Guns N' Roses guitarist Slash.
I was surprised even who I was, to tell you the truth. Well, it's like two different sides of the fence, I admit, but when it comes down to it, it's just like he dug what it was that I was doing, I dug what he does, and so it really ended up working, has anything to do with it. For the song, it wasn't one of the songs I played on, so I was a little bit reluctant to go up and sing to it, so he let me play live on it, which meant I could add my own whatever it is that I do to it, you know.
When you shoot with Michael, plenty of unexpected things happen, like a visit from his affectionate chimps during rehearsals. Of a very large statue honoring Michael's video music achievements.
We've made you this statue to show our appreciation for all you've done for music and MTV. And here it is, and it's rather large. Thank you very much. He has landed.
But the biggest surprise of all was Michael's elaborate production of Will You Be There?
Talented girl named Angela Ice, and she just broke my heart looking at her. She was just so there and calm and had the spirit of comfort that I was looking for, so she's our angel of hope.
I kind of give off this power of, here I come, everyone, you know, it's okay, here comes your savior, and then at the end I come down and I kind of wrap my arms around Michael, I told him to say, okay, it's okay, it's all right.
And I know that it is love. It's brighter than tomorrow. And if you really try, you'll find there's no need to cry. In this place, you feel there's no hurt or sorrow. Ways to get there, if you care enough for the living, make a little space.
Here with Michael today are some young friends from Los Angeles who will be joining him this Sunday. They're from two very special. I'll introduce them now.
At this point, I'd like to introduce Bert Fields, member of the board of directors of the Heal the World Foundation, who has devoted an awful lot of time to support this event.
Thank you. It's going to be a unique Super Bowl halftime show. Unique in that not only will millions of people all over the world be thrilled with the
opportunity to get out the message of the need to heal our children and heal the world. As Bert said, President Clinton's call on all of us to recognize that we need each other and must care for one another helped inspire us to develop this relief effort for children. To make a real difference, we must all care and commit to be part of the solution. I know you all share my concern for inner city children who are suffering all around us. We must join together to make this world a better place for each of them. Heal LA is only our first step in making things better. I'm very proud to tell you today that former President Jimmy Carter and I are going to be working together to help heal children in cities all over our country. President Carter will join me as co-chair of our new national Heal Our Children initiative. We'll work together here in LA to start, then go city by city to heal children all over America. I would like to express my love and appreciation to all of you who have already been so generous to this important new Heal the World program. My friend James Earl Jones and we, all of us, have developed a television message that will be broadcast following our Super Bowl halftime show. I'd like to share a preview of this with you now. Thank you all again for your commitment to heal our children and heal LA. I love you all. Thank you very much.
Okay, we're going to do the check for you. Listen, here, kneel down in front of me. Go ahead.
Here, you guys, get in.
Okay, one final photo. We'd like to get everybody on stage gathered around both checks. That'll be the final photo. Sharing this one. It's all right.
Okay, fine.
Okay. I know.
Okay, halftime is starting in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, track.
Unprecedented halftime performance, Michael Jackson will shine his radiant mystique to a worldwide audience of nearly a billion viewers in 70 nations. For 12 minutes, the NFL hopes all eyes will remain glued to the 50-yard line to see the world's hottest entertainer. Jackson will share the stage with 3,500 children of all ethnicities to create an electrifying scene.
We're trying to set up a full-blown rock and roll stage. It's 75 feet by 75 feet. It's got a band in it. It's got all the audio in it. It's got wind machines, smoke, pyro, the whole thing. And it comes out in 22 pieces. It weighs 10 tons, and we have 3 minutes and 20 seconds to put it together.
Jackson's show is more than the glitz and glamour he is known for. With his new anthem, Heal the World, he plans to send out a positive and uplifting universal message. It will promote his new foundation, set up to cure the ills of children in our own backyard, as well as in countries all around the world.
We hope when it's over that people will feel something, that this message of we must join together to kind of confront the problems of the world, that that has had, that we've made one little step forward in that direction. I think that's what his objective is.
Jackson's project isn't the only one offering a helping hand to children. The National Football League and country singer Garth Brooks are building the Youth Education Town, a community center in riot-torn South Central Los Angeles. It will give neighborhood kids a place to go, to learn, or to just play games. Children are the common thread at this year's Super Bowl. And for a few minutes tonight, the world will share their hopes. Hear the world, make it a better place.